Jack Nicholson turns 81 today. Let's celebrate with some of the actor's wit and wisdom. 101 advice. I hate advice unless I'm giving it. I hate giving advice because people won't take it. From Esquire's What I Learned, 2. On regrets, not that I can think of. I'm sure there are some, but my mind doesn't go there. When you look at life retrospectively, you rarely regret anything that you did, but you might regret things that you didn't do. From an interview with The Talks, 3. On death, I'm Irish. I think about death all the time. Back in the days when I thought of myself as a serious academic writer, I used to think that the only real theme was a fear of death, and that all the other themes were just that same fear, translated into fear of closeness, fear of loneliness, fear of dissolving values. Then I heard old John Huston talking about death. Somebody was quizzing him about the subject, you know, and here he is with the open heart surgery a few years ago, and the emphysema, but he's bounced back fit as a fiddle, and he's talking about theories of death, and the other fella says, "Well, great, John, that's great. But how am I supposed to feel about it when you pass on?" And John says, "Just treat it as your own. As for me, I like that line, I wrote that. We used in The Border, where I said, I just want to do something good before I die, isn't that what we all want?" From an interview with Roger Ebert, 4. On nerves, there's a period of time just before you start a movie when you start thinking, I don't know what in the world I'm going to do. It's free-floating anxiety. In my case, though, this is over by lunch the first day of shooting. From an interview with the New York Times, 5. On acting, almost anyone can give a good representative performance when you're unknown. It's just easier. The real pro game of acting is after you're known, to unjack that character, in my case, and get the audience to reinvest in a new and specific, fictional person. From an interview with The Age, 6. On marriage, I never had a policy about marriage. I got married very young in life, and I always think in all relationships, I've always thought that it's counterproductive to have a theory on that. It's hard enough to get to know yourself, and as most of you have probably found, once you get to know two people in tandem, it's even more difficult. If it's going to be successful, it's going to have to be very specific and real and immediate, so the more ideas you have about it before you start, it seems to me the less likely you are to be successful. From an interview with About.com, 7. On lying, you only lie to two people in your life, your girlfriend and the police. Everybody else you tell the truth to. From a 1994 interview with Vanity Fair, 8. On his sunglasses, their prescription. That's why I wear them. A long time ago, the middle American in me may have thought it was a bit affected maybe. But the light is very strong in Southern California. And once you've experienced negative territory in public life, you begin to accept the notion of shields. I am a person who is trained to look other people in the eye. But I can't look into the eyes of everyone who wants to look into mine. I can't emotionally cope with that kind of volume. Sunglasses are part of my armor. From Esquire's What I Learned, 9. On misconceptions, I think people think I'm more physical than I am, I suppose. I'm not really confrontational. Of course, I have a temper, but that's sort of blown out of proportion. From an interview with ESPN 10. On meters and directing, I'm a different person when suddenly it's my responsibility. I'm not very inhibited in that way. I'd show up on the set of The Two Jakes one day, and we'd scouted an orange grove and it had been cut down. You're out in the middle of nowhere and they forget to cast an actor. These are the sort of things I kind of like about directing. Of course, at the time you blow your stack a little bit. I'm a Roger Corman baby. Just keep rolling, baby. You've got to get something on there. Maybe it's right, maybe it's wrong, maybe you can fix it later. Maybe you can't. You can't imagine the things that come up when you're making a movie where you've got to adjust on the spot. From an interview with MTV 11. On Roger Corman, there's nobody in there that he didn't, in the most important way, support. He was my lifeblood to whatever I thought I was going to be as a person. And I hope he knows that this is not all hot air. I'm going to cry now. From the documentary Corman's World, 12. On playing the Joker, this would be the character whose core, while totally determinate of the part, was the least limiting of any I would ever encounter. This is a more literary way of approaching than I might have had as a kid reading the comics, but you have to get specific. He's not wired up the same way. This guy has survived nuclear waste immersion here. Even in my own life, people have said, there's nothing sacred to you in the area of humor, Jack. Sometimes, Jack, relax with the humor. This does not apply to the Joker, in fact, just the opposite. Things even the wildest comics might be afraid to find funny, burning somebody's face into oblivion, destroying a masterpiece in a museum, a subject as an art person even made me a little scared. not this character. And I love that, from the making of Batman 13. On basketball, I've always thought basketball was the best sport, although it wasn't the sport I was best at. It was just the most fun to watch. Even as a kid, it appealed to me. The basketball players were out at night. They had great overcoats. There was this certain nighttime juvenile delinquent thing about it that got your blood going, from Esquire's What I Learned.